Batman, also known as the Dark Knight, is one of the most popular superheroes of all time. He's been played by multiple actors on both TV and film, starting in the 1960s, from the Adam West TV show to Robert Pattinson in 2021. The man behind the mask, Bruce Wayne is the DC Universe's Tony Stark, from being a billionaire by owning Wayne Enterprises. We all know Bruce Wayne is unbelievably wealthy, but how exactly does he spend his millions? Don't forget to stay until the end of the video to see everything that Bruce Wayne has purchased from both comics and movies. Here are 10 luxurious purchases Bruce Wayne has spent his millions on. We're leaving out the obvious expenses such as Wayne Manor, the Batcave, Batman suits, gadgets, and his bachelor lifestyle. Number 10, a flying Batcave. Yes, you heard that right. In the 1950s Detective Comics 317, both Batman and Robin attempt to track down a rival gang by using a flying Batcave. It was an incredibly unique flying helicopter and included a super lab stacked with both art and trophies. It was also able to spit out an artificial cloud that made them invisible if they were under attack. Pretty remarkable technology for the 1960s. The fact that he only used it once and never again shows how rich Bruce Wayne really was if he was able to invent something that remarkable for just a one-time use. As cool as it looked, it's really a shame we didn't get to see more of it in later comics. Number 9, The Daily Planet. The Daily Planet, as most know, is the newspaper company that Clark Kent, Superman, works for. Although both Batman and Superman have been rivals on many occasions in the comics and on film in Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice, on many occasions they have considered each other good friends. In the early 2000 comics, Lex Luthor was running the Daily Planet into the ground and even wanted to close it down for good. So, Bruce Wayne decided to secretly buy all of the company's shares so that he would have complete ownership and reopen the company. Just like his secret identity as the Dark Knight, Mr. Wayne kept his purchase a secret to himself for a while, but when he publicly revealed that he bought it, his reason was simply, it was fun to own a newspaper company. While Clark Kent was annoyed by Bruce's decision at first, he ultimately appreciated the help and support while Bruce continued to fund the company. Number 8, Brother Eye. Bruce decided to build his completely own satellite system called the Brother Eye, so that he could keep a better eye out for other heroes in the DC Universe. Although the exact cost of this is unknown, we can all realize that it must be unbelievably bizarre. Bruce wanted to keep this cost private, which meant paying off others that knew about it meant spending even more money. It later backfired because the machines were later programmed to attack and go against humans instead of keeping an eye on them, which meant Bruce had to terminate the system. So much for helping out the other heroes. Number 7, The Outsiders. The Outsiders is a superhero squad that Bruce Wayne formed to rescue his close friend and business partner, Lucius Fox, who was kidnapped. He initially contacted the Justice League for help, but they were not available because Clark Kent told him that the League was informed that they were required to stay out of it. Since Bruce still needed assistance, he contacted and got together with a group of other younger superheroes to form a new Justice League, The Outsiders. He funded the operation and even provided them with housing in his townhome. He even paid for a member of the group, Halo's, college tuition. Eventually, after their mission to rescue Lucius Fox, the Outsiders went off on their own, but Bruce Wayne continued to fund the young superhero group. Sometimes the biggest superpower is a lot of money. Number 6, a secret city. Many people just do not realize how much of Gotham City is actually under Bruce Wayne's control. As a billionaire, there really is not anything he can't afford. Not only does he have every camera and every surveillance footage system accessed in his Batcave for the entire city, he also used cash from Wayne Enterprises to put up more cameras across the city that was not from Gotham. And since you never know what can happen, especially if you're a Batman, Bruce also has multiple secret bases and buildings across Gotham with access to weapons and first aid kits to heal himself. Gotham is basically an entire playground that is in Bruce Wayne's complete control, including an entire transportation system of tunnels underground so that he can return to his mansion unspotted, so his identity is not revealed. Elon Musk would be proud. Number 5, Earthquake Proofing Gotham. As mentioned about the secret city, Bruce Wayne loves to be prepared for anything, especially being Batman. And I guess that includes nature and the environment. Gotham City has always been set on the East Coast, near New York City. It is still not an area or a coast that is known for any tectonic plate issues, but every time Bruce Wayne has set up shop on a new Wayne Enterprise building, he has always insisted it to be able to withstand a 9.0 earthquake if the time ever comes. His business partners have always believed that it was a waste of money for an event that would never happen, but every boss's wish will always be granted. However, in one of the later comics, an earthquake actually hit Gotham, leaving the entire city demolished except for the Wayne Enterprises buildings. A spot on instinct and investment on Mr. Wayne's part that worked out tremendously in his favor. Number 4. Kryptonite Weapons. Although Batman and Superman are on the same team in the Justice League and often have appeared as friends in the comics, Bruce does not always trust Superman, and they have been known to have their issues in the past. His issues mainly revolve around the fact that he can't trust someone with that much godlike power. And since Bruce always prepares for the worst, he doesn't know if or when Superman could turn against Earth. Bruce has a packed vault in the Batcave with every type of kryptonite known to man. Bruce also spent a lot of money creating types of weapons for the kryptonite, such as guns, darts, and powder. It later turned to his benefit in the future when Kryptonians invaded Earth in the later comics. Batman seeded the entire city of Gotham with kryptonite that gave the civilians of Gotham a chance to fight back. So, if Superman ever turns bad, Bruce has enough kryptonite to completely annihilate an entire planet. Number 3. Bat Sentries. In the Kingdom comic miniseries, it is a future where many superheroes are retired, which meant a new era of superheroes to roam the Earth. After a natural disaster kills millions of people, brings Superman out of retirement, Bruce Wayne's identity as Batman is eventually revealed. When everyone figured this out, it left Wayne Manor completely trashed, which led an elderly Bruce Wayne to invest in robotic sentries to help protect Gotham. These bat robots patrol Gotham, surveying all crime, and does the job that he cannot do anymore, so he can enjoy his retirement more without being stressed about defending the city. Number 2. Lazarus Pits. Ra's al Ghul, as played by Liam Neeson in Batman Begins in 2005, has lived for centuries thanks to Lazarus Pits, which is a secret pool of energy, the energy that can heal others as well as extend the lifespan of a human, which explains why al Ghul has lived for so long. Bruce decided to finance scholars, researchers, and even scientists to get back at al Ghul to make the pits unusable so the pits no longer can function, which would eventually exterminate everyone benefiting from the pit's benefits. Number 1. Batman Inc. Bruce Wayne figured out at one point the public would come to the realization that he is indeed Batman due to the amount of money he spends, which makes a lot of sense considering Batman has armor, technology, and gadgets that only a billionaire would be able to own. With this realization, Bruce decided to come up with a plan. He put together a press conference to tell the media that he, for a while, has been secretly financing Batman the entire time. He opened Batman Inc. to the public and opened the opportunity to finance other superheroes across the world to be able to better fight their enemies. Bruce set up offices across the entire globe to help the system, which included weapons and other first aid kits. His message was loud and clear, but imagine how much he spent on Batman Inc. as a whole. As expensive as it is just to cover Batman's equipment, imagine the cost of covering multiple superheroes' equipment for the entire world. Bonus purchase? The Watchtower. Although Batman is the only hero in the Justice League without superheroes and not a godlike the rest of the members, he is still by far the wealthiest. When the Justice League formed, he used his money to finance the Watchtower, a floating station in outer space where the Justice League can meet to train, have meetings, and prepare for a potential threat. The main purpose was to defend against alien invaders with cutting-edge technology with labs, vehicles, and weapons. This kind of invest also requires a lot of maintenance and renovating since all the tech must be up to date and it must get trashed by the villains on a pretty regular basis. The monthly fees and renovations must cost a lot more than a Spotify subscription. Thanks for watching. Which one of these Bruce Wayne purchases intrigued you the most? Comment down below and don't forget to subscribe, annihilate the like button, and hit the notification bell so you're always notified when we post future videos. See you next time.